This would be one of those times where I would go and say something like, product haul. No, I'm just kidding. Or am I? Stay tuned. Hi guys, Matthew here, and welcome back again to my channel. So you know how some manufacturers make deals with other well-known brands so they can mutually create a product? Sort of like a crossover episode. Well, Logitech partnered up back in October with KDA, a virtual pop group placed in the world and based on the champions of the popular MOBA game, League of Legends, which resulted in 6 new products for their G gaming lineup, covering each segment, although based on the existing models. Putting that aside, I was actually really interested in checking these products out, because as you will now see, they have a unique and really cool looking colorway, so it's possible they could be interesting to users who are even outside of the KDA realm. They are all the same in their core, as they are based on the existing products and lineups, some of which I've reviewed long time ago. I'll put some links to that in the right top corner, but I am going to run through all of these products to see how they look and feel in real life, and not just as a 3D rendered item on a website. Although mouse pads are maybe not that exciting, I'm going to start off with one, that being the G840, just so I have somewhere to put next two products onto. It's a big XL size mouse pad with rubber base and cloth-like surface, and as opposed to other products in the lineup, here you will get to see the champions being displayed in their full KDA lineup. So we have Akali, Ahri, Evelynn, Seraphine and Kai'Sa. I really hope I'm pronouncing this right. Feel free to go at me in the comment section below if I'm not. I deserve it. What will I put on it, you ask? Well, this wireless G305 and the wired G502 gaming mouse, both being highly praised in their respective fields, carrying Logitech's Hero optical sensor. And this is where we come to that unique and cool looking colorway from before. I really like how both of them turn out to be, although I'm not that big of a fan of white color when it comes to maintaining the devices. Keeping them spotless is not an easy task. It does look cool with this black and blue detail combination, especially on the G502 where we have these additional blue details on auxiliary switches. Of course, you cannot spell gaming without a keyboard. Or can you? Never mind, you get the point. And here it is, Logitech's G Pro KDA mechanical keyboard. The base of it is obviously well familiar to all of us. It uses mechanical switches and RGB light sync backlighting for the unfortunately ABS type of keycaps, supports compact 10 keyless design, so all the regular bits and bobs for this model, except for one, and that being that this one uses GX Brown instead of GX Blue clicky switches, so have that in mind. This particular version of it shows off one of the most interesting looking application of the KDA colorway out of everything that I saw today. It has this sort of like half and half black and white design with KDA logo on the top, and this silver and blue striping reminds me a bit of Tron and Cyberpunk theme. And here is the well-known and pretty popular wireless G733 gaming headset. If you want to check out my in-depth review of it, be sure to click on the link in the right top corner. I also like it in this white colorway. They kept it really simple, which complements the physical design and lines of the headphones, plus the RGB strips get more pronounced. The only details that stand out are on the headband, again colored in the same familiar way, while on the side you can see the KDA logo. All in all, they didn't went overboard with anything on this one also. This is actually something new, or at least something I haven't seen or tried in person before, the G333 in-ear gaming headphones. I did saw them at a certain point, that being their G333 VR model, which is how they were first released, intended as an Oculus Quest 2 add-on. These ones are not that much different from it looks-wise, except of course having this KDA color scheme. What we now also get the 4-pin 3.5mm connector and a USB Type-C dongle, so you can connect it to various devices from PC, smartphone, tablet, PlayStation, Xbox, Nintendo and so on, with having inline microphone and controls. And this is the bonus release that I mentioned in the title, because with the introduction of the G333 KDA version, Logitech also released the so to speak regular G933 model for their ongoing G product lineup. You can find it in 3 different colorways, white, purple and this black one, and except what I've already mentioned, it also comes with its own carrying pouch. It has a dual driver design, one for mids and one for highs, and they do sound decent for IEMs, which are priced at $50. The only thing I miss having on them is a microphone mute switch, since they target themselves as a gaming headset. As for the pricing of everything else in relation to the KDA products, feel free to check that out in the description box down below. And that's pretty much it. As I said, all the links to these products, their specifications and prices can be found down below. And that is it from me for this time. Thank you once again, guys, for watching. If you find this helpful, please take a second to toss me a thumbs up, because that really helps a lot. And if you like what you saw, feel free to subscribe. And if you already are, be sure to press that notification bell down below so you don't miss out on a new video. Until then, catch you later, guys.